Punarvasi.com is my website where I use to write different step-by-step procedures on SAP basis administration. Many people got benefited from my articles. In this video, I'll show you how to install a add-on in SAP system. To install add-on in SAP system, you have to use the T code called SAINT, S-A-I-N-T. So this is the screen you will get once you run SAINT T code. Before starting the installation of add-on, just you have to copy the related file. This is the file I have copied to the directory C:\usr/sap-trans directory of my SAP server, and also SAP car exe file, which will be available within the exe folder of your SAP system, that is in the SAP EH7 DVEBMGS exe. From here, SAP car dot file will be there. Just you copy this, right click and copy and paste it into your trans directory. This is the trans directory, C:\usr/sap-trans directory. So once you have these two files, this is compressed file of the add-on. This is for uncompression, this exe file will be used. And just right click on this trans directory and click on the copy address. Go to command prompt and put cd space, right click and paste. Once you do this step, you will be redirected to that Perl directory, that is C:\usr/sap-trans directory. From here, you have to execute this Perl command, that is sap car hyphen xvf, sap car hyphen xvf space k hyphen 200 azin persos.sar. This is the file. Once you hit enter from your keyboard, the file will be extracted and it will be copied inside EPS directory. That is, EPS is nothing but electronic parcel service. In that, in directory will be there. In that, the file will be created. This is the file. Once you have this file within this particular directory, you can access your SAP system from anywhere. Like I am in the SAP server now, I am minimizing and logged into the front end, logged into the SAP system using front end software, that is SAP GUI for Windows. Once you logged in, just you have to click on install package, load packages from application server. From application server means it will look into the directory, that is in directory. Once you select this, let me explain you one more time. Just going back and from here click on the load, create this type of window, that is path ECC IDAS 7 SAP MNT trans EPS in folder. Click on the S button so that the file will be loaded into the SAP system. Okay, once you click on the S button, it will come to this particular window. Just go back from here. Just click on the start button. So like this, it will be displayed here. Click on the continue button. And so support package level is 0. Click on the continue button. And click on the continue button. Do you want to add modification adjustment transports to the queue? There is no need to do any modification adjustment. Click on the no button here. And without password, this particular add-on installation doesn't need the password. If it needs the password, you have to go through this particular SAP note. The password will be there in this particular note. Click on the continue button. Okay, the process will be started in the dialog mode. Just accept the defaults. If you want to change the start options, you can click on the start options and you can choose the background so that the operation will be, that function will be run in the background immediately. But in this case, just I am running, click on the continue, and now click on continue, click on import. So it's performing the job. I'm pausing the video here. I'll come back with the completion screen. So this is the final screen. The installation, the add-on was successfully imported with the displayed queue. Choose logs to display the import logs. Choose finish to complete the installation. Click on the finish. The add-on installation queue was confirmed. Okay. Let us check this particular add-on whether it is installed or not. From the system, click on the status. Go to component information. Just look for the components which we have just installed now. You can search for that. PRS. SAP GUI personalization, that is POSOS 200. Okay, in that way you can search for the component. Okay, I hope you understood how to install add-on within an SAP system. Thanks for watching. If you have any doubts and questions, you can leave your comments in my website, that is www.punarvesi.com, or under this particular video.